We know that flowers are the reproductive parts of a plant. But how does sexual reproduction take place from these parts? Do they lay eggs like animals? Or can they regenerate into new plants like a starfish does? Well, actually, it happens when a pollen grain from the anther reaches the stigma of a flower. Agents such as winds, animals, insects disperse pollen on the stigma. And this process is called pollination. Based on mode and agents, pollination has been classified into self-pollination and cross-pollination. If a pollen grain reaches the stigma of the same flower, it is called self-pollination. If it reaches the stigma of a different flower on the same plant, it will still be called self-pollination. But if the pollen grain somehow reaches the stigma of a flower on a different plant of the same kind, it is called cross-pollination. Sometimes, pollen travels hundreds of kilometers to land on a stigma. Now, you may be wondering how pollens travel from one plant to another? Yes, the pollen is transferred by various agents called the agents of pollination. Lighter pollens are generally transferred by wind, while in aquatic plants, they are transferred by water. They usually travel from one point to another through water currents. Some pollens are also transferred by other organisms such as insects. The insects are attracted by bright colors, petals, and scent released by the flowers. When the insects sit on the flowers for nectar, pollen grains stick to their bodies. Now, when they sit on a different flower, the pollens are released on the stigmas of this flower. Upon pollination, the pollen grain germinates and transfers the male gamete into the ovule. The male gamete then fuses with a female gamete to form a single cell called zygote. This process is called fertilization. After fertilization, the ovary ripens to become the fruit and the ovules develop into seeds. The zygote develops into an embryo, which is surrounded by a protective seed coat. But what happens to the other parts such as sepals and petals of the plant? They dry out and just fall off as the flower forms the fruit. You may see remains of sepals in guava, the green part at the top. You may have eaten different types of fruits. They may be fleshy or juicy, such as mangoes and oranges. They may also be hard, such as almonds and walnuts. Having said that, this was all about pollination, fruits, and seeds. Let us summarize what we have learned. The first step of sexual reproduction in plants is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of a flower. Wind, water, insects, birds, and animals are some agents of pollination. Pollination leads to fertilization, in which male and female gametes fuse to form a zygote. After fertilization, the sepals and petals fall off and the ovary ripens to become fruit. Some fruits are fleshy while some are hard. So this is the end of the module. Thank you.